What's going on, y'all? Hello, hello, hello. What's happening? Hey, let's get it on. Hey, oh, baby, come on in. Let class begin. Come on in. Come on in. Class is about to begin, y'all. I got to tell you, it's been an amazing, amazing, amazing day. The day has been so amazing. I don't even know if I could share everything with you guys, but I am so excited to be here. Let me see. Let's see. Come in, lounge, jumping off. What's going on? You said that intro is everything. Yes, I love that intro. That is my, I love it. And you can find them. They're on YouTube, y'all. They're on YouTube. Let's go. I don't know what I did with my speaker to play the bell ringing, but I got it. So we are good. So here we go. Let me get up my other side over here that I was looking at. I said, oh, I got to share this with my teachers tonight. I got to share this. Boom. Here we go. All right, let's go. So I got I'm working three screens tonight, y'all. We about to go in, y'all. Y'all ready? All right, let's rock and roll. All right. So I am that teacher. What is I am that teacher? It's that teacher that's willing to go beyond the walls of their classroom to impact the lives of their students. And they're not waiting on the administration to tell them what to do. They're not waiting on a parent. They're not waiting on a kid to step up. They just waiting on themselves. And that's what it takes to be that teacher. Let's go. We have to be extreme. We have to think differently, y'all. Let's get it. All right. Oh, I think I missed one. Hold on. Yeah, there we go. Repost. Tag a teacher. Repost. Tag a teacher. Come on, Lucretia. I see you. Lucretia out here. I see you. What's going on? Hey, Janine. What's up, Faye? All right. So we are in the building tonight, y'all. Let's go. Let me get this where it needs to be. I like it low right there, but all these cords connected, that's irritating my soul. All right, let's rock and roll. Okay, so don't forget, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Janine gonna drop the link for you. She's gonna drop the link. Let's see where we are. Let's see where we are. Let's get it, y'all. Let's get it. All right, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Valari Humphrey. My goal for this month is to be at 300. That's not my goal. I think we should be at 325 by the end of the month. We should be at 325. Let's do 350. We're going to be at 350 by the end of the month. Let's get it. 350. I'm claiming it in advance. 285. Oh, we'll be at 300 by the end of the week. Come on, y'all. Let's just take baby steps. 300 by the end of the week. Let's go. 300 by the end of the week. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. All right. So review what we talked about last week. We talked about improving student motivation. So we talked about managing anxiety, make goals high but obtainable, and give learning feedback and offer changes to improve. We talked about a lot of stuff, but that's the main thing. I just wanted to review those things. All right, so tonight, what are we talking about? We're talking about non-threatening formative assessment techniques. Non-threatening formative assessment techniques. This kind of tickled me in my studying today. I was like, that's pretty good. I never thought about assessments being threatening. It's like, how can an assessment be threatening? But I love. Y'all ready? Let's get it. So we talked about index card summaries and questions. So I'm reading right here what they said. Periodically distribute index cards and ask students to write on both sides with these instructions. Side one, based on our study of the unit, whatever the unit topic is, list the big idea that you understand and word it as a summary statement. Meaning, from this unit, I understand that. Boom, I love it. Side two, identify something about the unit topic, whatever it is, that you do not yet fully understand. And word it as a statement. I don't fully understand blah, 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 about blah. Boom. Guess what that does? It's an assessment. That's non-threatening. Because you're saying, I don't understand this. Boom. You're not giving me a test. So it's, oh, that's good. That's fire. Hold on. I need to pull up this because I printed this out as well. So I was trying to pull it up so it wouldn't be so I wouldn't have to look over there. I could look down. I don't have to look at y'all like that. Okay, here it is right here. Boom. You ready? All right, let's go with the next one. I'm going to be looking all day. All right, So the next one, y'all got that index card summaries. I love that one. That was good for me. Next, hand signals. Oh, this one was interesting. You ready? As student ask students to display a designated hand signal to indicate their understanding of a specific concept, principle, or process. I understand blank and can explain. Thumbs up. I do not yet understand blank. Thumbs down. I am not completely sure about blank. Thumbs sideways. So up, I got it. Down, I ain't with you. I'm a little off on that. Y'all like that? I think that was good. That's some flexibility with that. I've heard of that before. That wasn't new to me, so I've heard of that one before. Yeah, right, Jeray. You said thumbs up, thumbs down. Yep, and then the one sideways. Yep, and that's cool. Let's go. 1 minute essay. This one got me. I was like, whoa, what? 1 minute essay. A 1 minute essay question or a minute, 1 minute question is a focused question with a specific goal that can, in fact, be answered within a minute or two. You got that? So let me read it again. A 1 minute essay or a 1 minute question. 1 minute essay question or 1 minute question is a focused question with a specific goal that in fact, that can in fact be answered within a minute or two. So you set it up and you structure it where they give it, it's a 1 minute, you got 60 seconds to answer this question. Boom. It's an assessment. It's non-threatening. It's not really a right or wrong. It's just a check and connect. Analogy prompt. This one was good. Oh, I love this one. Present students with an analogy prompt, a designated concept, principle, or a process. Is like blank because blank. So the concept is like blank because blank. So they comparing it to something. All right, let's look in the comment lounge. Let's see what's going on over here. Also, so you use the all right, Jeray, I love it. She says she used the thumbs up, the thumbs down. She uses that with kindergarten. I love it. I love it. That's good stuff. And then I learned this strategy at a teacher class. I learned, let's go. Let's go. Definitely, definitely. Yes. She learned it at a teacher class that she took. I love it. Let's get it. All right, misconception check. Y'all ready? Present students with common or predictable misconceptions about a designated concept, principle, or process, ask them whether they agree or disagree and explain why. The misconception check can, I'm moving my mic, can also be presented in the form of multiple choice or true or false. It can be a true false quiz. Now check this out. You know how they have, let me try to find one real quick, but they have the signs. Like you can make the signs and on one side, you can have truth or false and the kids hold the truth or false cards and they hold it up, turn it around and they just hold it up. That would be pretty cool. Get some popsicle sticks and some construction paper. You can get popsicle sticks and some index cards and just tape it on there, tape them together, put the popsicle stick in the middle and they can make it themselves and make it true or false. If you buy color cards, boom, you can make one side yellow, one side red and you can do true or false. Right there. It could just be an impromptu thing. That would be great. And you can collect them up, distribute them out, and the kids can make them. I love that one. Love it. Let's go. Now, here's the deal. Formative assessments, techniques to check for understanding, and processing activities all help with comprehension. So if you're just trying to teach, basically your thing is to teach for your kids to understand. That's all that matters. You're trying to get your kids to understand. So what can happen is, I'm not doing that. You checking for understanding. That's more important than you getting to an assessment or grade. And look, this is a way for your kids to master the skill. It's not about the grade. It's mastering the skill. Mastery is more important than grades. I keep telling y'all this. Master the skill. Help the kids master the skill. It's not the grade. It's not the grade. It's the mastery that matters. It's mastery that matters in education, not the grades. They'll remember a skill they learned, but they may not remember the grade they got. Come on. Oh, that got good to me on the inside. I was like, oh, come on, y'all. Let's get it. So with that said, I'm not tearing, y'all. I'm doing good. I'm at 13 minutes. I'm ready to rock and roll. Let's check the comment out, lounge out. Let's see what's going on here. So Lucretia said, this is a favorite. Oh, the hand signals. Yes, yes. Say, we use a meter to tell how comfortable we are with the lesson. I love it. I love it. To the left, I'm not understanding straight up. Or straight up, I got it to the right, if I understand. Oh, to the left. Oh, okay. Got it. Got it. You move the meter. Oh, I love it. I had to get it. I was thinking while I was talking. All right. She says, okay, we use a hand meter to the left. Oh, okay. Okay. I got it. Tell me if I got that right. So to the left, in the middle, to the right. Okay. I think I got it, y'all. I think that was good. That was good. All right. Janine says, you can also utilize their superpowers and help them understand what it is. Yes. Yes. Good stuff. Good stuff. Mastery is more important than grades. Come on, Lucretia. Yes, it is. I promise you it is. Mastery is more important than grades. We out here trying to, you know, push grades and kids getting 4.0s, but they stupid. Oh, did I say that? I apologize. I apologize. I shouldn't have said that. All right. So back to you. Mastery is more important than grades. Let's go. All right, y'all. I am not here to push. I just want to drop nuggets every night. Something you can just use in your classroom tomorrow. I'm not trying to do this whole big initiative that you got to think, you got to break stuff down. My goal is to help you find something that you can use tomorrow and it's simple to implement. Simplicity. Simplicity is what's important. And from that, we all grow. I promise you, we'll all grow. All right. I'm out of here, y'all. Tonight, that's it. That's all. Says the clock on the wall. I'm going to find my speaker. You know what? From my assistant. It says, I am that teacher. It's a bell. Look. And it says, I am that teacher. So I might be ringing the school bell from now on. Right. Let's go. All right. That's it. That's all. Says the clock on the wall. Go be amazing on purpose. Don't let nobody tell you not an amazing teacher. Because you know why? You are that teacher. Let's get it, y'all. See you. Have an amazing day.